I have a saying, and I think it works right here. Why are we always accepting excuses for failure, and we're not out there seeking reasons to succeed? We went out and said, how can we succeed?
When are we going to start the quotation?
We are Vaughan-Bassett Furniture Company. We have been in business since 1919. We make wood bedroom furniture. 98% of what we make is made right here in Virginia and North Carolina. 2%, or less than 2% actually, we import. We've met the foreign competition. We've met it straight on. They did not put us out of business. And we decided 10, 15 years ago, we were not going to remove our plants out of this country. And we have succeeded being a domestic manufacturer.
Why are we here today? We're here today because Vaughan-Bassett's growing like a weed. Sales were up 19% in the fourth quarter of 2011 and continue to be up over 20% so far in the first quarter of this year. The American consumer is buying our furniture and American-made furniture at a faster and faster rate. The people in this room, our workforce here at Vaughan-Bassett, deserves all the credit for this. You people have proven that we can compete and defeat any competitor in any country in the world. And I'd like to thank you and congratulate you. But our success has created a problem. We've reached our capacity here at our Galax plant, running full time, but our customers are asking for even more Vaughan-Bassett furniture. So what are we going to do? Can you hear me? I don't know if I have a voice as loud as his anymore. I want to be sure you can hear me. What we're going to do is expand. We're going to grow.
We want to expand because we don't want to grow. We don't want to keep shrinking. This will give us the ability to continue growing. And as we work out of this housing problem, and we will work out eventually, we will. We feel that we'll have that factory in several years working full blast.
Well, this is the day that we really wanted to happen, and we've had to wait a long time for it to happen.
We never stopped making furniture, and today's news is further proof that we never will. But I don't know if you know who Warren Buffett is, but Warren Buffett is one of the smartest investors that this country has ever seen. And he has a wonderful saying. He said, talking about investing money, he said, if you wait for the robins to come back, and if you wait for the dogwoods to bloom, you're too late. Guys, this is January. The robins aren't here, and the dogwoods ain't blooming, okay? But come April, we will be here.
My grandfather started the Bassett Industries in 1902. I grew up in the little town of Bassett, Virginia. My father was, until his death, the chairman CEO of the Bassett Industries. So being the only son, I was immersed in the furniture business. I worked as a very young boy. He paid me out of his own pocket when I was old enough to be hired by the industries. I started right in the factories, measuring lumber, doing all that type of thing. Graduated from Washington and Lee, went to the Army. I was in 3 years of reserve, but I was 3 years active duty in Germany. Worked for Bassett until I was 45. Then my wife's family, who had this business, asked me to come up here. I came up here in January 1983, and I've been here ever since. We have been employing people in this community for 90 years. We have 650 employees. And many of them come from families who've had fathers who worked here, grandfathers and grandmothers and mothers, aunts, etc., that worked here. People say Americans can't compete. Americans can compete. You look at these people, you don't see anybody lazy. They do it on their own. Americans are very efficient people. We have to give them the right equipment. We have to give them the right surroundings. We have to give them the right products. But Americans compete with virtually anybody. At least I can say that as far as wood bedroom furniture goes, because that's what we know. You wake up in the middle of the night, you look at the ceiling, and you say, okay, guys, are we going to be here? And the worst thing we could do is panic. So as a leader of this whole company, I was not going to telegraph any shots out there that we were afraid we were going to disappear.
You know, everyone thought we'd all lose a job. Even this plant here, everyone thought it would close eventually because all the other factories around here have closed. And they kept thinking, well, how can they survive whenever everyone else is closing? It was hard. Yeah, but John kept informing us and telling us what he was going to do to change it. And, you know, to me, I knew he would do the best he could and do what he could to keep his company afloat. And he did.
My grandfather was in the Great Depression. I say what we went through was worse than the Great Depression for this reason. When we recovered from the Great Depression, we recovered domestically. Americans still made the product. As we recover from the Asian invasion, it's probably not coming back unless you stayed domestically like we did. So we had to make a decision. We had to lower our costs. Every single market we went to, every single, virtually every year, what we made had to be made less expensively because the price kept going down and went down and went down and went down. It's called deflation. We met that. Our people worked with us, we worked with them, and we lowered our cost of manufacturing, and today we're still here.
We go around the world looking for state-of-the-art equipment. There's a machinery show, the International Woodworking Fair, in Atlanta every other year. There's also a even bigger machinery show in Hamburg, Germany, that we're one of the very few American companies to go to Germany looking for machinery. We're fortunate in that we have plenty of money in the bank and no debt. And when we see equipment that will lower our cost and make us more efficient, we write a check for it. And almost no other company in the United States is pursuing that strategy.
In 2011, we bought our first 5-axis router. And we were amazed what it could do. Very complicated piece of equipment. But the people here learned how to run it, they learned how to write the software. We added another 5-axis router at the end of 2011. We're adding the third 5-axis router by April 2012. And if we need more, we'll buy more. I think we probably have the most efficient bedroom factory in the world. Not just United States. I know we have the best in the United States. We have the best in the world. And if today, if you're going to pay American wages, you pay American benefits, you're going to do all the things that we need to do on EPA and EEOC and OSHA and everything else, which we all believe in, hospitalization, retirement, you can't do this unless you have the most efficient factory in the world. I'm backing off all the time. But I'll probably go out of here feet first. It's in my blood. It's a passion with me. Am I doing less all the time? The answer is yes. Are my sons doing really running the business? The answer is probably yes. But if I think they're going in the wrong direction, I will point out this didn't work in the past. Maybe it won't work in the future.
Anything else going on?
I'm in the middle of reading the Steve Jobs book right now. And the part about my father that reminds me of Steve Jobs is that he does not take no for an answer. Like Jobs, he's a perfectionist, and he's extremely effective in getting his management team and his workforce, his entire company, to do more than they thought they were capable of. And I think that's a key reason that we're still here.
I wanted to be known as a person who really cared about their people. And I want everyone, not just at the top, to do well. I want to leave this community with a better company and better jobs and more security and a work ethic that was better than it was when I came here.